Okay, so hi again. So I hope you are doing good. So this is a guitar session, and what we want to do this afternoon is just to see again something from Python side. Yes, always in the same way, our objective for this week: help you setting up very well your working environments. So this afternoon, we are just going to see in Python how do we make sure we have our data science libraries. Yes, so a quick tutorial. So I'm sharing right now my screen. Can you see?
Yeah, you can.
Okay, good. So think, where is the, no, it's not here. Let me see. Yes, I okay. So this is our tutorial. Now I just want to share, it's not something complex, it's very simple. You just have to go and make sure you have all your data science libraries installing ready to use, because for the coming week, we are going to work a lot with Python, and especially using data science things. So Python is a general programming language, but to actually do data science in Python, the Python programming community has already developed some libraries to do that. So you know very well the data science libraries. Normally, I shouldn't do this tutorial, but I want just to refresh you about maybe a few things you may be missing to check. So later you just have to go from the tutorial later and see. Yes, whatever you don't have, you can actually manage to do that, because now you have the skills to do everything. So now so I wanted to introduce you to show you some of the libraries actually requires when you are doing data science. Yes, if you manage to install them this week, that means that for the coming week you will just be using them without dealing with any installation issue more. So that's why I just made this notebook to share with you the one I found very useful. I may be missing something, is nothing, because you guys know actually the most important libraries. If I'm missing something, just check it, add it, and install it, and it's okay. So I just want to be sure. And you have this notebook actually in your today folder, so that later you can just go through and see. So I actually classify those libraries into several categories. So you guys already know in the data science workflow, you have a lot of steps. Yes, so the steps are just described and can be actually classified into the following steps here, like the data gathering, data cleaning and transformation, data visualization, data modeling. And so we could also have audio and image recognition. This involves advanced technique. Yes, image recognition for deep learning, for example. Audio recognition also for natural language processing, just web. So it depends on your area of work. You will actually need some of the libraries, and that's why I'm going to share with you. So I'm starting with the data gathering. So most of data analytic project, yes, can Most of the data analytics project start from data gathering and extraction. Yes, that's right. So sometimes the data set might be given when you work for a certain company to solve an existing problem. Yes, sometimes you just have your data at your disposal, but some of that time you could not get the data. Maybe you don't have the data and you are gonna collect the data by yourself. Yes, so now you have this scenario in more of the cases. Let's say, for example, you are working with a company, then they want to collect the customers, they want to collect the customer's opinion in number of products or services, for example. So they want to collect the customer opinion and point of view about how the quality of service is running, or yes, what are the experience. Then you have to run, you have to collect the data by yourself. Yes, so now, so the most common scenario is that you need to crawl the data from the internet. Yes, you can actually go in the file, collect the data. Yes, so there are tools available for that. This is not a problem, but you can actually require, for example, to just collect the data from internet. Yes, you search data from website to website, then you collect them. So this is the kind of things we call web scraping. Yes, so because you will visit some web page, some website, and from there now you are gonna collect the data, yes, directly using API. So now that's why I wanted you to make sure you have actually Scrapy installed. So Scrapy is probably the most popular Python library when you want to write a Python crawler to extract actual information from websites. Yes, so for example, you could use it to extract all review for all the restaurant in a city, or collect all the comments from a certain category of product on an e-commerce website. Yes, so this is also possible. So now you know what Scrapy do, and it's used to scrap data directly from web and within your programming language, which is here Python. So I just want you to make sure, so go check in your pack, in your libraries, if you have it. If you have it, okay. If you don't have it, make sure you install it. And then, so to install Scrapy, here you have the command, so the pipe command. So pipe install Scrapy will just install Scrapy for you. So if you don't have it in your Anaconda libraries, just use the pipe or the Conda command to install Scrapy. So yeah, I told you it's not something complex. I wanted to show you just to make sure. I just want to keep your attention on the most used data science libraries nowadays, and just make sure you have them, because in the next week or in the coming week, maybe you will not have time to install all those. So make sure in this week, when you have, I know you are busy with your project, but when you have a time, just pick some to check if you have them install. If you have them, it's okay. If you don't have, install. And yes, if you install, just find, you can actually find online some sample of code to actually test your package to see if the library is working well. Yes, so for example, this is for Scrapy. Yes, so you can actually, if you run, so this is more like using Scrapy. So you see it's here importing Scrapy, and then if it's not installed, you will install Scrapy, then it will import it. And so if you are able to do such kind of things, you should just run those kind of code and make them work. And once they are able to, they are running, if they provide a good result, then you know, yes, my Scrapy is ready to use. So this is the only way you can actually check if your library is ready to use. I don't know if this one is working actually, but manage manage to test the environment. If it's working, that's okay. Yes. So yes. So this is about Scrappy. And now Beautiful Surf, I think you guys saw that one with Yabi last time on the tutorial. I think maybe it's the Google Sheets tutorial, I don't know. So this Beautiful Soap is yet another Python library for scrapping web contents. Yes, to scrap web content. So apart from Scrappy, you have Beautiful Soup also. Yes, so it's generally accepted that it has a relatively shorter learning curve compared with Scrappy. Yes, so also Beautiful Soup will be better choice for relatively smaller scale problems. Yes, so feel free to check if you have it. If you have it, it's okay. I know you have working in Twitter mining, data collecting, collection from Google Sheet, working with Yabi. I think you may have installed most of them, but just wanted you to check if you don't have any of them, just make them just call them, install them, and make them ready. Be sure they are working so that for the following week you are not gonna have any problem about your libraries. Yes, so here is a code to actually check. Later you just have to run it and see if it's working. Yes, that's fine. That means your environment about these libraries is just ready to use. So there is also Selenium. So Selenium is another libraries. Yes. So develop it to be an automated web testing framework. So however, developer found that it's quite convenient to use it as a web. Yes, so as a web scraper, yes. So this is actually is usually used when you have to get the interesting data after interaction with the web page. So for example, you may need to register an account or then log in and get the content after clicking some buttons or and links. So these links are actually defined as JavaScript functions. So in this case, usually it is not easy to use Scrappy or Beautiful Soup to implement. So but Selenium is actually the best thing, the best tool you can actually use here. Yes. So in your data science life, you will probably need those kind of things. Maybe we are not going to use them all during this training, but it's good. You know that yes, I have this option. I have also this other option. So from now, maybe you have been using only Scrappy, maybe Scrappy or Beautiful Soup, but you know, you don't know the limits of Scrappy or Beautiful Soup. But here, for example, by reading this, you know that yes, if I want to deal with this thing, it's better I focus on Selenium. So now you are maybe not going to use it here in this training, but as a data scientist, I think it's good, you know that, and you know how it's work. Yes, so if you don't have it, try to install. And the challenge, the weekly challenge, I think you are free to use any tool you want. Yes, so feel free to call your to be creative. Yes, if you think yes, doing this is just more optimized than doing by another way, just try yourself, be creative, because this is how data science should a data scientist should do. So be creative, don't focus on the only one tool and only one tools you already know. Be like open to the world and try just to explore. If you already know how to use this, yes, so now why not try to use this other one tools to check about if I can do the same thing. Yes, if you cannot do, you know, yes, there is some limit with this one. Maybe it's from my side, or maybe it's in their side. The tools don't just allow to do it right now. So I know that yes, if I want to do this, it's better now I focus on that tool. But if I want to do another thing, yes, I would then come back to these tools. So that's why I'm telling you about those things. So if you don't have it, please install using this command. If you have it, it's okay. Yes, then you have to test it to see, yes, if your things is working. So now about data cleansing and transformation. Yes, I get it's not necessary to claim how data cleansing and transformation are important in data analysis and data science. Yes, so there are also too many outstanding Python libraries that do this well. So now you guys know that Pandas and NumPy are just the most used Python libraries when you are working as a data scientist, when you want to deal with data science project. Yes, those two are the most important. So I don't think I have something to teach you about those one, but whenever I know, I just provide information to check. So if it's not working actually, just try to install it. But I think if you have installed Anaconda distribution of Python, then Pandas and NumPy just come with. Yes, then you will have just to see updates. So make sure also, apart from installation, those you have installed already, check about the version you have actually. And if you have new version, yes, please update to have some new features. It's always good to have update version. Yes, so now Pandas and NumPy, you know how to test those one. I'm not gonna teaching you anything. So Pandas for data frame, NumPy for array computation. You have also CPy. So CPy is probably not as famous as the previous one. Yes, but while NumPy and Python and Pandas are the libraries dealing with numeric and structured data, Spicy just help us to convert free text into structured data. Yes, converting free text in actually structured data is very important because, you know, collecting data from Twitter or Facebook, yes, which other social media, I don't. So collecting data from the data you actually take from those social media are just on structured data. Yes, so how can you actually manage the unstructured data and put them in a nice structured data format? Yes, with columns, yes, with rows, with column separator. Yes, so Spicy is actually a good thing for that. So Spicy is one of the most popular NLP, yes, natural language processing, but because, yes, it's still with text mining. So when we talk about natural processing language, that means all the language, all the natural language that exists. So it could be testing, it could be actually audio, yes, file, yes, so things like that. So natural language processing libraries for Python. So Spicy is one of the most popular NLP. So if you want to deal with NLP, which is an advanced data science techniques, yes, Spicy will be very useful. Yes, so install it, because later I think by the end of this program, yes, we are probably going to talk about some deep learning techniques, so including image classification or NLP for, yes, so it then Spicy will be very useful. So I wanted you to check if you have it. I don't know if it's come with the Anaconda package. I don't know if it's inside, so if it's there, that's okay, but if not, just install and then make sure you have it. Make sure you have it. So here, for example, you have a sample of code. So there you have how to install Spicy. Very simple, just the pipe command. Also, I think you can also use the conda command. Just try, and so after that, I think it's okay. So now coming to data visualization. Data visualization, you have you saw that a lot with my colleague Sebastian, and you saw that with Siabon. I didn't even put Siabon here, but I know you guys know and you have already installed it. So because I know Sebastian was very focused on that one. So Sebastian and even matplotlib, you have, and I think matplotlib, this one even come with the Python description of the Anaconda description of Python. So check it if you don't have installed, and you can actually run this code to see if it's working. But I know it's working your side because, yes, you all did the visualization task in the pre-assessment week, and I think without that you cannot do it. So just see again if you have a update about the version. Just try to install. It's good you have the latest version. Yes, make sure all those libraries are working, and it will make more easier the coming week, because you cannot be dealing with libraries and installation at the same time and have a difficult week challenge. I know the weekly challenge are very challenging. So if I wanted you to save time, that's why check if you have you think about anyone I didn't mention there, which is also useful for data science. Yes, just install it and be sure it's working. Then you are just gonna be use them later instead of dealing with installation things again. So this is Plotty. Yes, so matplotlib is a must learn library for visualization. Yes, most of time I would prefer to use Plotty because it's enable us to create the fanciest graph, yes, in few lines of code. Yes, so if you don't want to write a lot of code but produce actually good plot, yes, I think Plotty is very nice for that. So you can check it. So it's good you have a lot of options. You have Seaborn, actually, you have matplotlib, you also have Plotty. I think something I will, for example, do to test, to play with is, for example, try to produce the same graph or the same plot with the tree and just compare the appearance to see which is doing better than which is doing the better plotting things. So then you know that, yes, if I want to do, for example, a bar plot, yes, Plotty provide a nice things to do that. But if I, for example, want to do another thing like plotting the distribution, for example, yes, then you know that probably you are going to use matplotlib, or if you want to do something else, yes, you know that probably you are going to use a Seaborn. But it's good you know you have a lot of options, so that if you are just dealing with one of them and it's not working, then you will just have to move to the other one. So data mining, data modeling. Yes, so when data analytics comes to modeling, we usually refer to advanced analytics. So nowadays, machine learning is already not a novel concept. Yes, because everyone knows machine learning, but everyone don't know how it works. So you guys you know the basic about that, and you probably know more and more. And yes, that's great. And here you are going to also get a lot using the challenge. You are gonna also learn a lot about that using the challenge. So it's good you have the libraries you will require for those challenges already. So that's why here you have scikit-learn. So scikit-learn before scikit-learn should be installed in Python before you start dealing with machine learning. Yeah, so 6 different major model in scikit-learn. So with only this package, only this library, you can actually do data pre-processing, dimension prediction, regression, classification, clustering, model selection. Yes, so I think those are very this is very important as libraries. So I highly advise you to install this one and make sure it's working perfectly, because this one, it's like your second pandas. So if pandas, you cannot actually deal with or manage any data set without pandas, then I think you cannot at least start any machine learning. I think you should start from here if you want to deal with machine. I know there are other libraries. Yes, like Keras, like TensorFlow. I know there are a lot, but this one I really like it. It provides nice modules. Yes, I think. Yes, consider that. At least dealing with not so huge amount of data, not big data. At least you can use it until the time you want to deal with big amount of data. So then Python just become slow in working, and you will have to use some big data real world tools Apache. Apache tools, how do we call the data science programming environment? I forget about that one. I will remember later. So Apache to process big data, we are using Adobe. Yes, but Adobe do Adobe have a machine learning framework? I don't know, but the one who have a machine learning is Spark. Yes, so Apache Spark actually is very useful if you are dealing with very big amount of data and you want to process your machine learning. Yes, so there is a machine learning package here, and you can even connect Spark with Python. I think with Python and with R, I did it before, and I used to do that. But yes, so for this time, you probably don't need that because it's only become necessary when you are dealing with very, very huge amount of information. Yes, like you want, for example, to process billion of line in few seconds. So then Spark become very useful because of its parallel computation framework. Yes, it's very, very, very fast and very useful, but later you will see that. Yes, so this is a sample of code to actually test your scikit-learn. So what I want you to remark here is that the name of the package is scikit-learn. Write it like here, but if you want to call it in Python, it's just sklearn. So it's the same thing. So it actually provides a lot of function, and I just use the Iris dataset. So Iris dataset is actually located even in Pandas and in R. So I use that because it's very useful to test machine learning algorithms. So if you run it and it's working, that means, yes, your scikit-learn is ready to use. And that is great because you are really going on. Definitely you need that in the coming weeks. Very useful. So apart from that, you have of course another data science library like PyTorch. So you have PyTorch and other also like TensorFlow. So here I provide you the entire process to actually make sure you have PyTorch installed. Yes. Yeah. So okay. PyTorch is more Pythonic in terms of its syntax. So it's good to have this one also, and this is the way to install it. Yes, so I just repeat, install Anaconda. You already have that. Open Anaconda prompt. Yes, you have it. So just directly go in your Anaconda and just type conda install PyTorch. Yes, you'll get it ready. And TensorFlow also. Yes, how do you make it ready? TensorFlow, another machine learning library for Python. Yes, that was open sources by Google. Yes, so one of the most popular features of TensorFlow is the data flow, a graph, and TensorBoard. Yes, very useful library, and also very useful for deep learning. Yes, if you want actually to train images, to classify images, yes, TensorFlow is actually a very good tool. So I think it's very good you install it. And So later, the letter is an automatic generated web. Yes. So it's actually very good you install it, because I think more of the chat, when we will come back, we will come with some Kaggle challenge, for example, like the one I showed you last time when I was dealing with Colab. Yes, collecting data for using the Kaggle API. I think I deal with a cancer detection data set. So the cancer detection data set actually is, I think, formatted as images data. So you have cells image, affected image, and safe image. Yes, so you have the cells image, and then the only one thing you need to do that is deep learning. So image classification to actually detect if the cells of someone is actually infected by cancer or not. So computing probability that the cells are affected or not. So then I think TensorFlow is very useful here for this deep learning things. So it's very good you install it and just try, see the process here. To conduct, you will create, you have to create an environment for TensorFlow, and you have to activate your TensorFlow. Yes, and it's all you need to do. Yes, so follow the steps and install it and make sure it's working. Yes, and so other things are audio and image recognition. Yes, audio and image recognition are deep learning techniques. So machine learning is not only on number, but also can help on audio and image. Yes, that's why it's come to deep learning. So now video are considered as a series of image frames. So yes, so a video is actually a concatenation of a series of video. So if you have a 60-minute video, for example, just think about that like a series, a lot of image. Concatenating, merging, and then you have your video. Yes, so as you are merging images, then the is becoming bigger, and then the size of the video is, yes, the duration is just rising. Yeah, you know. So before, when we deal with this multimedia data, those machine learning library will not be enough. Yes, the machine learning library like scikit-learn will not be enough when we want to deal with audio or image data. As in Kaggle, we also have competition about audio. Yes, and as a data scientist, I think it's great you deal with those things to see at least once to see how it's work. So it's actually good you install the libraries related to those one, like Libroza, like OpenCV, and check whatever you find. Just install. It's good you have it. Yes. So now from web, you have Django, you have Flask also. Yes. So that's all I just wanted to share with you this time. Is nothing else. I know you are working in your project. It's very, very good this time. Continue in this way. Just make sure you have all the libraries of data science you are gonna use in the following week. Just make sure you have all of them installed and ready to be employed. Yes. I hope you enjoy. So this is all. Let me see the question. Yes, 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 yes. Things sure. Machine. So machine learning is under data modeling. Yes, machine learning is under data modeling. Machine learning is under data modeling. So there are sometimes statistical modeling, and now there is machine learning. You know, statisticians don't always consider the prediction. They are more about checking let's say the model properties and the causal factors. So they are statistician. I'm also a statistician. I know statisticians are always doing like causal analysis. So how do we know about how much this variable is gonna impact this output? Then we define a significance level, and we say yes, at a level of 95%, we know that this is gonna impact this output. Yes, so and we did a lot of causal analysis, and yes, we don't care a lot about the prediction. Yes, so now actually, if you take, for example, a logistic regression model, yes, it's a modeling technique, but it's also a machine learning techniques, because yes, machine learning, the main objective is to train your data on, to train your machine on your data, and then to use a machine to predict new data. Yes. Now, the logistic regression, yes, if you want to use in the side of statistical modeling, yes, it's like the same. You are gonna just use the model to fit, you fit the model with your data, and from the model now you get the output. You say, yes, this variable is impacting this. So you have an output variable and you have input variable. So you say my output variable are impacting my input variable. Yes, at this level of significance, I'm confident this variable is impacting this. But and how much the variable is impacting, you also know that. So if you have a variation of the input variable by one unit, you know it's impacting the output variable by this number of units. So it's just that I think statistics don't really care about the prediction, but it's care about how good the model is, what are the effects we can actually analyze in the model, what are the interaction between the variables, what are the causal effect, and yes, so more about statistical property of the models. And now machine learning will just care about the performance of the prediction, and yes, cross-validation to make sure you have optimized everything. Yes, really nice. Yes, so cool. So I think I'm done. I will let you continue working in your challenge. Very happy to share this with you, and looking to talk to you later. If someone else don't have any question, then we end this session. Okay, people are joining, but we finish. Yes, so I think later you have the recorded video. Yes, sure. So thank you guys, and